The Canes are 10 over NHL 500 on the road. Boston is 15 over at home. The game is on. The Bruins got off to a great start. Jalen Chatfield waits for a complete change. Dmitry Orlov cross ice, dumps it in. Natchez, and where is it? Natchez has his hands in the air, and the referee is pointing at the goal. Caught swimming off his post.
Almost like a set play, because Natchez is going to get to this puck first. You can see the reaction or lack thereof of Swayman when Deschaz has this puck. I mean, he's almost even with the goal line when he just whips it at the Bruin goaltender.
Ooh.
And I'm not sure who actually puts this puck in the net. It was, you can see it right along the goal line. Gloves off, stick, his helmet. He's going to come over for the photos.
Ghislain Hébert.
What does that mean? Florida's basically going to run the table.
Two on one, Frederick and Boqvist. And Frederick sends a laser wide. DeBrusque out of the corner. Carlo. Oh, Frederick had the puck find him. And Kochetkov all over Causeway Street. I wondered what was going on. Martinook. Breaking with Stahl, tries the short side, a Swayman save. Stahl has it come off his stick. McAvoy slings it to Marchand, to Coyle. He goes hard around. Pasternak in first on the forecheck. Carolina's clear, hits the Bruins stick. Jarvis turns and Swayman recovers. Self Jarvis back to Aho. Pesci through the slot. Pasternak stick handles over the Golden Bee. Marking the centennial season. Zacha hard off the boards. Carlo Zacha with Wotherspoon. Grizzlick in and out of Kochetkov's glove. Through 18 minutes plus of play, territory is paid for. Geeky dinks and moves.
And staying with that strict rotation is much harder with circumstances in playoffs, but I think we see both guys.
All right. Geeky pats it back. It was headed to goal. Karen Vinen. Aho catch and release. Aho to Jarvis. Turns on the end boards. Hampus Lindholm gives it away, and Nason is stopped by Swayman. Nason keeps it in. Shea, a glove save with a flourish. Into McAvoy's skates, and Sebastian Aho sends Seth Jarvis ahead, and Swayman reaches out.
Across the ice to find McAvoy coming late, but it's in his skates. Now he had disadvantage. Heads up play, Aho with the steal, little self-pass, gets some separate.
Career year, stuck on 29. Touch pass, springs a two-on-one, Frederick. Saved by Kochetkov.
Two on one. Good job in the neutral zone. We talked about Carolina trying to take away time and space and gap up.
Deflected just wide. Let's go Bruins, the champ from the TD Garden faithful. Martinook, saved by Swayman on Svechnikov. Carolina swarming the Boston end. Svechnikov off the goal frame.
He's saying it went in.
Oh, yeah. It was off the frame of the goal, inside the goal.
This is the angle you need. There, that confirms it.
Yep.
After review, the shot at 9:05 for Carolina fully crossed the goal line. Therefore, this is a goal.
Orlov lifts the pass. Svechnikov didn't miss by much. Svechnikov elevates the pass. Burns throws it down the slot. And a score by Teravainen, sliding it underneath Jeremy Swayman. It's 2-0 Carolina.
Policy when you play against this team. And then they win a puck below the goal line. Again, they use that low to high game. And it pays dividends. Even though Burns' pass attempt, you know, one of those shot passes doesn't connect. It's more pressure deep in the Bruins zone.
Reverses to Lauko. The diagonal to McAvoy. Swings it in front off Frederick's skate. McAvoy back to Boqvist. Centers Lauko. And McAvoy drills it past Kochetkov.
Credit. We said they needed a shot in the arm. They had some real good entries. They created three real good scoring chances. Only one got to the net. That was the redirect by DeBrusk. But then they follow up. 5-on-5. Good pressure. It was all put in play by Charlie McAvoy, and he ends up being the goal scorer. He's the one that rushed the puck. He got it into the offensive zone. He didn't vacate too early. The Bruins keep the play alive. They get a good break there on the shot block by Lauko.
No, sir.
And he's been their best option tonight.
Yep. Father Spoon. If the Bruins can't get a clean entry with possession, what do they do with the puck? Meanwhile, Lauko, a clean entry. And Kochetkov makes the save.
Jacob Lauko able to take that nice post up center ice pass with speed down that left wing. Gonna lean in with that right shoulder and right leg, protect it, just couldn't quite finish off the play he was looking to make.
Gensel out to the blue line, into the corner. Jarvis to Orlov, a blocker stopped by Swayman, and a goal for Carolina. Jake Gensel made the play when he knocked down Charlie McAvoy's airborne pass.
Well, this is what Carolina does because of their relentlessness. They keep plays alive. Looks like Boston was going to have an easy exit out of the defensive zone. And Orlov creeps in. He gets this feed from behind the net from Jarvis. And it's a pretty good stop by Swayman high. Kind of blocker side, but it breaks through, and Zacha's going to reach in behind and try to bang it out. Banged it off the back of Swayman, and then maybe back off the stick of
Foss off the boards. Carlo taps it toward Grizzlick. Foss centers, a blocker stop off Drury. Just about a must-score power play for Boston. Seth Jarvis whips it on Swayman and wraps it on. And he has 30 goals on the season and sends the crowd climbing the stairs to the exits.
Get this crowd excited to get behind you. And I'm not sure what the Bruins' game plan here was if they lost the draw to the strong side corner. I mean, Jarvis just flies the zone. There's no defensive pressure there. There's no urgency to get all the way back and maybe help out your goaltender. It looked like Swayman kind of overcommitted a little bit to the shot. I get it. He's got to be aggressive. He's got to take that short side away. And then in his attempt to get back to the, you know, the response here by Carolina, their ability to execute their game, their style of hockey, was just as clinical.
Shea saved by Swayman. Orlov wands it to the end boards, and the siren sounds. Boston in a 9-game run against playoff teams